Okay. Good morning. Let's start today's session. And the first card is Professor Jeromek of his on the morphism of a cosine variety.
Start. Hi. Thank you for giving me the possibility to have a lectures in such an exotic country as India. Thank you. I would like to say a few words about the group of automorphisms of affine variety, or more general, quasi-affine variety. Yes? Automorphism group of automorphisms of... maybe you should start this, okay? Affine of affine quasi-affine variety. Of course, I would like to recall that quasi-affine variety is simply open subset of affine variety. Yes, it is more general notion. Of course, every affine variety is quasi-affine, but not conversely. And but this group is complicated. In fact, it is complicated, and still we don't know. We don't have much information about the group of automorphism. Yes. For example, there are some. Maybe first I state my results, okay? And I would like to show the proof of the following theorem. Assume that X is a quasi affine variety over an algebraically closed field of characteristic zero. If X is not uniroot, this means simply, if you have variety X, yes, then we say that it is uniroot if for every point in X there is a rational curve through this point, okay? Simply it is filled by rational curves, yes? If X is not uniroot, then the group of automorphisms of X is finite. And conversely, for every finite group G, and every N, there is a even smooth affine not uniroot variety X and G such that the group of automorphisms of X and G is precisely the group G. Now this means that more or less we have the full characterization of group of automorphisms of not uniroot varieties. Okay? But however, the general case, I would like to mention here the general case of the, in fact, I focus only on this theorem. However, let's see what is the general case, this uniroot case. Yes? It is quite complicated because we have the following very interesting example of Al-Houthi. I'm not sure I correct name. I have to check. Al-Houthi, I'm sorry, Al-Houthi. Al-Houthi, it is around, it is very old example, however, yes?
What does
IN
stand for?
Which? N is dimension, I'm sorry. dimension. In every dimension, you can construct such a result. Yes. Usually, here is a dimension. Okay. Okay. And we have the following. It is very interesting example for us, for the people who work in algebraic geometry. I find algebraic geometry. However, it seems that almost nobody knows these examples. Yes. Included, yes. The example is the following. If you consider the following surface, it doesn't matter, plus minus, is equal to constant C. This is X. XC. Yes? Then the group of automorphy, this is of course uniroot. You can check that it is uniroot. Well, you can use this theorem also to check this. And we have X is a free product. Two, because there are reflection. That, yes. And semi-direct product with the permutation group of S4. That you see, it is infinite group of automorphies, but discrete. But discrete, yes. It's very interesting example. And it needs further study, in my opinion, yes. This example, we should go back to this example and recover this example again, yes. It is infinite group, but countable. Yes, but anyway, in general case, there is the following conjecture of Kraft and Seidenberg. If X is affine, and the group of automorphies of G is not discrete. No, this means that it contains family of mappings, yes? Then, either C plus or C star acts on X. In particular, this implies that X must be root variety. Yes. 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 C not zero. Yes. C not zero. Maybe sister. This is very old paper, yes, it is published in, it is Soviet material, it was a Soviet mathematician, yes, it is, yes. Yes, student of money, yes. Maybe, not, however, this is really interesting example, really. Yes, it is cubic. Yes, there are reflections. Yes. Yes. These are in fact correspond to three reflections, and these correspond to the group which preserves this cubic. This comes from rational mappings. This comes from regular mapping. This comes from this non-rational reflections. Okay, and now this is very nice theorem. It is the future. Yes, the future to prove this very nice theorem. Probably this conjecture should be true. Yes. Yes, and if it's true, we can even state this theorem in stronger version. Yes, to say that if X is not root, then the group is. Yes, something like this. Yes. Yes, family. algebra. It is in the sense of Ramanujan, yes? Because it is definition of non-discrete part. It is first stated by mathematicians from India. Yes? Okay, and I would like to prove. Maybe first I prove some easier part. Anyway, I construct for a given group G. Yes. But this is unipotent, and this is sister action. Even this one-dimensional. Of course, it could be this or this. Yeah? You have take C or C star as examples. Yes, of course. And maybe I start to prove this easier case. Namely, let us fix the finite group G. G finite. And I would like to construct the non-univalent affine variety, which has G as a group of automorphisms. Now, I first start with dimension one, okay, x1 G. I would like to construct this, and to do this, I consider the following mapping. First, of course, from elementary algebra, there exists the group of permutation Sn large, Sn large, such that G is a subgroup of Sn large, okay? And then I take all Vieta polynomials, symmetric Vieta polynomials of n values here, okay? I have a mapping S, which is S1, S2, Sn. There are all symmetric polynomials, yes? It is from Cn to C, or any field of characteristic zero here, yes? First observation is that it is finite mapping on which the group Sn operates freely, yes? These fibers of these mappings are invariant with respect to action of S and X, which transform X1, Xn, sigma, which is simply the permutation given by sigma. Okay? And the fiber of these mappings are invariant under the action of this group. And then you see, take here a general hyperplane. Then the pre-image of this hyperplane for general H is irreducible. It is simply Bertini theorem. Of course, it is maybe not direct application of Bertini theorem. However, if you resolve singularities at infinity, you can reduce this theorem directly to the well-known Bertini theorem. Okay, it is enough to resolve the singularities at infinity. Yes, and then we can continue. Yes, and finally we have a surface, pre-image of the surface which I contain by X. Yes, to C2. And here I can consider some irreducible curve of genus greater than zero. Probably it's enough to take the line. However, I don't want to check this. It's enough because it's no problem. I take here a curve. I take here a curve of genus greater than zero, and I take a pre-image. Then again, by Bertini theorem, this is irreducible curve. Yes. Then I obtained here a curve gamma, which is irreducible, on which acts the group Sn. Yes, on gamma, you see, we have a curve with action of the full permutation group. Yes, and now it's easy to finish. Yes, take a generic point. The point which is not contained, which has maximal fiber, which has maximal not fiber, but which the number, the group is maximal. Yes, the number of points in this is maximal. I'm sorry, in orbit. I'm sorry, with maximal orbit. Okay, then get x0. Then it's enough to take as our curve x1g simply g minus x minus g x 0. Yes? Because you know any other element of a group of automorphisms could be extended, yes? And if it is not in this group, it must transform x0 to another element, it is contradiction, yes? That in group of automorphisms of this complement are exactly the group from the, are exactly element from the group G, okay? That is very simple construction of, we have automorphism x1g is exactly g. And now it's easy to finish, to have a general case. We need only the following lemma. What? Could you repeat? Yes.
You take the product with the
Yes, of course. It's a natural approach, yes. Of course, I do exactly this way. But I need this lemma, yes? Lemma. If G1, G2, Gn are curves, affine curves, affine curves is such that genus of G1 is less than genus of G2 is less of genus Gn, then the group of automorphism of product is simply the product of group of automorphisms. And now you, as you said, yes, we can choose gamma 1 as here. And here we choose these curves with trivial group of automorphisms, yes? And it is finished, in fact. Okay? And now I would like to sketch the proof of our main result, yes? How to prove that if X is quasi-affine variety of an algebraically closed field, then the group is finite if X is not univalued. But first, I need some old-fashioned concept of Weyl divisors on normal varieties, okay? But it is very useful here. Of course, Weyl divisors are not so good as Cartier divisors. However, under some additional assumption, they works very good, okay? And I need this language here, okay? Let me recall that if X is variety, then Weyl divisor is simply a combination the I and I belong are integers and the I are hypersurfaces. This means that they are codimension one. It is not hypersurface does not mean here that it is given by equation, simply that it has a codimension one. Or maybe better to okay, and I would like to create some notion of pullback of such a Weyl divisor. However, you should be here. You should be very careful, because in general, of course, does not exist a pullback of Weyl divisor under the rational mapping, yes? Usually it does not exist, in fact. It maybe exists, but it has very bad properties, yes? But I would like to restrict the class of the mapping which I use in this way that I can use this notion, yes? Now maybe I have a following lemma. If Z is a subset of X and and J. Ah, of course, we can consider in the class of dimensions, we can also consider the relation of to be rationally equivalent. Yes, it is the same definition. It is exactly the same definition. Of at least if X is normal, or if the singular set of points of X is small, it means that it's codimensional at least two, at least two. Yes. Yes, and. Let J be a mapping from maybe X. I'm sorry. X prime is X minus Z. And now J from divisors of X to yes, and this mapping preserves J preserves linear equivalence, and is surjective. And what is important for me, it is isomorphism. Iso codimension Z is, of course, it's obvious. This lemma is obvious, but that is important in our construction. Yes, and then we restrict here to the mapping X, Y are normal, always, yes, and we will consider the rational mapping from X to Y in the following way. This is, or maybe, yes, it is a rational mapping. But our extra assumption here to build this all good properties of this matrix is the following. What is the image? Yes, of course, the image of the set F is by definition F X. Here, normal projective is X minus the set of points F, fundamental set. Simply, okay, and F minus 1 R is simply F minus the rest, we can R minus C. And we consider here F only in the domain, okay? There are two definitions. Okay, and our condition is the following, that the pre-image of the set of a singular point of Y has codimension greater or equal to 2. And in fact, if we have this this notation, we have these properties, that we can construct the theory of divisors in more or less in the same way as in the Smooth case, more or less in the same case. Yes, in particular, we can define a pullback of a divisor D in the following way. We simply restrict our attention only to a part where this two divisors, only to a smooth part. Yes, here we have X, here you have Y, here you have D. We remove singular set from here, we remove singular set from here, then we make a pullback, yes, and After this, we simply take a closure of components. Yes? And if you check, this is a good construction. Yes? Good construction. In fact, the problems are only in the, if you would like to construct a pullback, in general case, is only in this case when the pre-image of singular set is contains divisor. Yes? Then it is not possible. Maybe it's possible to define, however, it has not good properties. Yes? And we can prove the following theorem. A theorem, maybe, proposition. If f x to y has property, then the support of a pullback of a divisor D coincide, yes, and we simply, if you have canonical desingularization, that it has important property that if you have a time mapping, that the pullback of this mapping is also a tile, yes? If you resolve singularities in the canonical way, yes? And I use this, in particular, automorphism are lift to automorphisms, yes? And then I take here, what I have to prove? I have to prove the following theorem that if X is quasi-affine, then X has a good cover. And then if X is quasi-affine, then of course X is contained in affine variety. And this affine variety is contained in some projective variety, yes? And of course, divisors x1 minus x1 is big. It is even ample, yes, even very ample, yes, okay? But it is for us, it's important that it's big. And then, please, we can take canonical resolution of x1, yes? We obtain here canonical resolution of x1, and please note here that here we have maybe S, yes, that S, D is also big, of course, is also big, and moreover, group of automorphisms of X is contained in the group of automorphisms of S minus 1 X, yes, and we have Z. We can define Z as an algebraic variety which is equal to Y minus S minus 1 X. Now, this is some algebraic subset which contains a big divisor as a subset, a support of a big divisor as a subset. And now we can use, we can consider the sheaf of ideas of Z, and we can use procedure of principalization of this sheaf of ideas. Exactly as in the paper of Godarczyk, Kolar and so on. Yes? And then we obtain, after this, maybe it's Y1 and here is Y. Okay? This is principalization, and after this we obtain what? We obtain here, we does not change S minus 1 X. However, the set Z now is a divisor with only normal crossing. This is not important. However, it's a divisor. Yes, this is a divisor which contain a pullback of what is here is P, which contains a pullback of a divisor it was S. D, yes? This Z is goes to the hypersurface which contains a pullback of this divisor, a support of pullback of this divisor, which this support is of course big, plus something effective. Now of course by our theorems this is also big, yes? And then if we put all this together, we have the following, we have this theorem, yes? And now we can finish in the following, I need also the following, maybe basic things, is that enormous progress in minimal model theory, which is done by many mathematicians, this is, of course, but it is wonderful progress here. And I use exactly this. Yes? Many people from the minimal model program constructed so-called quasi-minimal models, which are very useful for me. Okay? What does it mean, quasi-minimal model? Simply, definition. Yes? Let X be a normal variety. D a divisor. Q divisor. Q cartier. Then we say that D is moved if the linear system for some D, if for some large D, the this divisor is integral, is Cartier divisor, and the system generated by this divisor has not fixed components. Okay, this is a definition. And then we say that a variety, Q factorial variety X is quasi-minimal, minimal, if there exists a sequence Dn of movable divisors D1, D2, such that in the group, narrow Severi group of X multiplying by Q, this space is a final dimensional space. Yes, and as you know, the real final dimensional space has unique topology. Then you can induce topology here, and we can say about notion of when sequence can tend to some elements. Yes, if there exists sequence of divisors such that in this group Di goes to Kx, okay, recently, there was not maybe recently, a few years ago, it appears some series of beautiful papers. Among them, one of the results will be that every non-linear variety has a quasi-minimal model. But for me, quasi-minimal models is at most, in fact, minimal model, because I demand only one property, yes, namely the following property, which is satisfied for quasi-minimal models. Namely, the following theorem: biaxial group X for quasi-minimal model X, we have the following: biaxial group of X is exactly the group of automorphisms in codimension 1X. Yes, this means simply that it's very nice group. It's very nice, and I can use all these tools which I constructed here, because I have only grouping. Then I can finish. I'm sorry, a few minutes. That I, well, maybe I sketch only the proof. Yes, that if we have our quasi-minimal variety, we can construct here a good cover. Here, yes. Why? And here acted the group G. The group G here acted. I assume that X is not unit first. Yes. Then I can construct this cover. Good cover of X. Then I have here a minimal model. Maybe minimal model. Maybe also X. Oh, okay. I have here a minimal model for this, and you see here group G acts, then in some sense also group G acts here. However, this mapping is a contraction, because in the process of construction minimal model, we contract only, we use only the visual contraction and flips. This means that if I consider the mapping P minus 1, this mapping does not contract any divisor. Does not contract any divisor. Yes? And I can use, for example, the theorem that the pullback of this big divisor here is also big divisor here. However, by a construction, the group, maybe here I have D, here I have D1. By the construction, this group G preserves this divisor D1. Yes? And I can use the theorem, which I proved before, yes, that I have a representation of the group G to the linear group, to the linear group of the variety X prime, which is birational to X tilde. Since this variety is not unit, also this variety, which is birational to X, is not unit. Yes, no, but I have here infinite group G, which acts on here, and by the Rosenthal theorem, it means that X must be unit, even root. Yes, this is a contradiction. And this finish a proof. I'm sorry, I have 1 minute. So, 3 minutes. Thank you. Yes? No. Then I have a divisor here. Yes. And I push down it here. In fact, I have D1 is P minus 1 pullback of this by P minus 1. Yes. This does not contract divisors. This means that it is well defined and it is big. Yes, and then by construction, I have in fact X minus singularity of P minus 1. Here is embedding by Zariski my theorem. Here is embedding. Then in fact, the element of G here behaves as element of G here. But this element preserves the set Y minus B. That this means that also elements of this group preserves the set X tilde minus D1. But this means that component of the divisors D1 are simply permitted by G. But this means that this divisor is preserved. Yes, if it's preserved, we can use the theorem which I proved before, that for big divisor we have a representation here. Yes, and this representation is a bijection. Yes, yes, to the group of linear mapping of the variety X prime, where X prime is simply I m D1 of X tilde. Yes. And since this is not unirood, also this is not unirood. Yes? No, but it is a contradiction, because if you assume that it is an infinite group, that infinite algebraic group, because you can take closure of this group in the group of linear mappings, it is an infinite group which acts on nonlinear variety by Rosenthal theorem. If infinite algebraic group acts on algebraic variety, it must be root. This means root. Rosenthal. Theorem of Rosenthal. If G algebraic F I group non-trivial F I group infinite acts on X, then X is birationally equivalent to Y cross P 1. Birationally. In particular, it must be unirood. Yes, it is a contradiction, and this contradiction finishes the proof. That's all.
Any other question?
What?
That's Rosenthal key result.
Yes, yes.
Sir, I wanted to ask yes. you where and how you use the function of non-unirood.
No, here, for first here, and the second here, that only for non-unirood variety I have quasi-minimal model. Without this does not work at all. Yes, I thought about some possible generalization. However, this is the main obstacle here. Yes, this theorem works only for non-unirood varieties.
Finite, you have to
No, no, because I prove this by contradiction. I assume that X is not univocal, that it has infinite group of automorphisms. And then I would like to deduce a contradiction, yes? Exactly this, yes.
Okay.